And the answer is log base 2 of n. Note that 2 to the power of the number of steps equals the number of elements. So we would say that the step complexity of this parallel algorithm is O of log n. So if we reduced 1024 elements, we would see that it would take 10 steps compared to 1023 in the serial case. This is 2 orders of magnitude fewer steps, and now you're starting to get an idea of why a parallel implementation might get significant speedups. However, note that it can only get these speedups if it has enough processors to handle all these operations at the same time. If we're adding 1024 elements in parallel, our first step requires performing 512 additions at the same time. Now, a modern GPU can actually handle this, but if we're adding a million items in parallel, our math would tell us we could finish in 20 steps, but would also tell us we'd need to perform 500,000 additions at the first step at the first time, which is not too likely given the desktop hardware we have at our disposal today. That's okay though. Even if we're only keeping 500 processors doing additions throughout the computation rather than 500,000, that's still an enormous speedup over having only one processor doing additions. It's a good exercise to work out how many steps it takes to run this algorithm for an input of size n if you have only p processors. This is called Brent's theorem, which the interested student will want to look up and perhaps discuss on the discussion forum.